The most specific MR sequence for diagnosis of multifocal intracranial cortical subcortical microhemorrhages in cerebral amyloid angiopathy is, the answer is gradient echo. Remember that for any hemorrhage, the most specific sequence or the most useful sequence is gradient echo. Basically, there are two types of MR sequences, pin echo and gradient echo. Gradient echo is the one which is good for hemorrhages. So what is gradient echo? GRE, as it is called as a gradient echo sequence, it is sensitive to changes in local magnetic field. Blood products in hemorrhage, they have paramagnetic property, that is, they cause change in the local magnetic field. Hence, gradient echo can detect those changes and hence it is useful in hemorrhage. So this blood products, they have susceptibility effect, but because they are paramagnetic, susceptibility effect means basically they change the local magnetic field and hence they decrease what is called as T2 star relaxation time. So if there is a decrease in T2 star relaxation time, gradient echo shows that areas as black. So hemorrhage will be black on a GRE. The more sensitive sequence for hemorrhage, more sensitive than GRE or gradient echo, is SWI, that is susceptibility weighted imaging. As I mentioned, susceptibility means susceptibility effect, that is change in magnetic field, that is blood products. So SWI is more sensitive than GRE for hemorrhage. So if we have a look at the images, gradient echo and SWI in this patient of amyloid angiopathy, these tiny black areas here, those are the micro hemorrhages. And we can see that in SWI, much more hemorrhages are seen as compared to GRE. Hence, SWI is much more sensitive than GRE for micro hemorrhages. So if in the options gradient echo and SWI both are there, the better answer would be SWI, that is susceptibility weighted imaging. So remember that hemorrhage anywhere in amyloid angiopathy or hypertensive angiopathy or any hemorrhage, it is GRE and SWI.